Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. A great night for baseball ahead on the show. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Minnesota Twins. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go now. Starting on the mound in this one, Chris Paddock. What do we have on him?
Well, you don't always know what to expect with this guy on the mound to start the game. He can be really good at times and turn in some real excellent efforts. For me, it'll tell us a lot to see how he's attacking the strike zone and pitching aggressively or not. If he's doing that from the jump, I think he'll be fine.
Nice for the Yankees. And stepping in for the Yankees, Gleyber Torres. The 1-1. And that's outside. And that is cut out and missed. 2-2.
Well, when those hitters count, sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And that's the first out.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Out. Did a nice job right there.
And the righty deals. He swings and fouls one off. One out, base is empty. Pitch misses, counts full, 3-2. Outside, and that is ball four.
You know, I think he's okay with that outcome. It wasn't an intentional walk, but he wasn't exactly trying to attack the zone either.
It's Aaron Judge now. And that's, no, that's off it. The inside edge. And it's 2-1. Soto, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. And Judge spoils that one. Pitch. Center field. Makes the catch for the out. Two away now.
That is cool. The first base.
Here's a look at Aaron Boone's lineup for the Yankees. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These players have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
That one's in there. Now 1-2.
A 1-2 count, all he's seen is fastballs. You've got to expect something off speed. Stay back.
He goes down looking. The Yanks leave one, and now the Twins will go to work on offense. We've got no score. You're dialed into the show. Here with my pal Siggy, and on the hill in this one, Carlos Rodon.
Well, there are going to be a lot of balls in play because of the ground ball rate. Important that the defense stays engaged in the game. I think it's critical the tempo is there. If you run quickly, it helps the fielders behind you to stay engaged, to make those plays and help you get through the innings.
And another ball That misses the zone. And the count is 3-1. Out towards right center field. Sizes this one up. One down. Okay, let's check out the lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
High fly ball out to center field. Judge is there. They got it for out number two.
Batting third, the catcher.
Ryan Jeffers at the plate.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field. But he can jump you if you make a mistake.
Oh, he doesn't get the call. 2-2. Good eye in that spot.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Full count.
Outside, and that is ball four.
Now, this is a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past. It's an issue once again early on.
Two outs, runner at first. Max Kepler at the plate. Rodon fires. That misses off the outside edge. Jeffers leads off first with two down to the inning. That one misses. Now 3-1. Carlos Correa to bat next. And the 3-1. Foul ball there.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Two outs. Got him looking for the K. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. On to the second from Minneapolis. No score. Second inning set to go. Now up is the Yankees DH, Giancarlo Stanton. Here's a 1-1. Swing it a foul straight back. Hammers that one deep left field and forget it. He sends it out of here. And they grab the lead. It's 1-0. Alex Verdugo.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Here's a 1-2. And another ball.
That's a ball.
Freddie Ferguson behind the dish, calling the balls and strikes. Here's a 2-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Righty to the plate. To the right side, and that one handled. He'll do it himself, and that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
The shortstop, Anthony Volpe.
So digging in, Anthony Volpe. One out, base is empty, and a run in here at the top of the second. Righty delivers. And that one lifted in the air center field. Makes the grab, two down.
Batting it. The catcher.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Austin Wells. The 1-1. And that one wrapped foul. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That one carrying. Back. Gone. That one felt good. It's their second home run of the inning. It's 2-0.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
So two away with nobody on. Oswaldo Cabrera stepping in now for the Yankees. Next offering is down low. Two outs, base is empty. And the pitch. This ball's chopped on the ground. Miranda. Now the throw to first on the run. And the inning is over. But two round trippers in this inning. The long ball was working. And it's 2-0. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back in Minnesota, we head to the bottom of the second. Now it's the shortstop, Carlos Correa.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
The wind of the pitch. Bounce to third. Throw on to Rizzo, and Correa retired.
Batting six. No left fielder. Trevor. Larnach.
Here's Trevor Larnach. One down, base is empty. And a foul ball. And now the lefty swings and misses, and there's two away.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there, not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Hard on the ground to first. Rizzo takes it to the bag, and the Twins go 1-2-3. Nothing doing here for the Twins. They trail it here 2-0. Back in Target Field, top half of the third inning. Now it's the second baseman, Gleyber Torres. And a 1-1.
Ball.
You know, these Yankees showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
And now the count filled up 3-2.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
That one back up the middle, and it gets through. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Look, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
And now it's Juan Soto. That one finds the zone. And a count. 1-2. The pitch. And another ball. Though Chris through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. And now 2-2. Ground ball right side, could be two. It's in and out of his glove. But the throw to first gets him easily, and that's the first out. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Wouldn't chase that time. Judge rips that one. And it's into the gap. Coming home. Cut off, throw to second. And he's in there as a run scores.
He was all over that one. Nice line drive to the low side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
And it's second with one away. And here is Anthony Rizzo. Kicks and deals. Fouled off. He was late.
A defensive swing right there. Some cheese on the inside part of the plate. But the hands are still stinging after that one.
Man at second.
2-2.
In the dirt. And an excellent job keeping it right there. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Here comes a pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Sizing this one up. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Up next for the Yankees, the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. Runner at second, two down. We're here in the top half of inning number three. And another ball. Next one misses. Three balls and a strike. And it's fouled away. Man on second, two down. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boom, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Oh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Inning over, and it could have been worse. Yankees strike for a run on the RBI double. It's now 3-0. Back after this on the show. And we're back. And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. A wind and a pitch. That one is absolutely belted. And it one-hops the wall. Around first and hustling for second. Not in time. That's a leadoff double.
All over that one right there. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
So up next, Jose Miranda. The lefty ready and a 1-1. Out to short. The throw to first. One gone, bottom of the third inning.
Now that the designated hitter, Alex Kirilloff.
So the batting order turns over. Alex Kirilloff, the next twin up to hit. Santana leads off second with one gone in the inning. Slider misses outside. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. They won't risk the send. Runners at the corners now with one away.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. You see a ball come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, you know, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the exit velocity? This time, 106.
One away, runners at first and third. And now for the Twins, Edouard Julien. Started to swing, held up.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
And there's the strike.
Great spot to be in right here for the pitcher. You can either strike this guy out or get a ground ball double play.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. To two now. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. One run across. Rounds third, headed for the plate. He'll score. Two runs are in. It's 3-2.
Well, he wasn't afraid to hit with two strikes. I think he choked up a little bit, maybe spread out, but he got the job done right there.
One out, runner at second. So up next for Minnesota, Brian Jeffers. Rodon ready. Here comes.
No, that's down. Oh.
And the throw. He's out at third.
Especially when you're trying to swipe third base, you have to get a decent jump off the pitcher. That wasn't it right there. And even though the throw skips in, they still slap the tag on him in time. Not a great attempt right there.
The pitch.
Nope. Oh.
There's ball
That's
four.
Ball four. Take your base.
Oh, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taking ball four.
Runner at first with two away. And now the right fielder, Max Kepler. Next offering is in for a strike. Home team down a run. Here in the last half of the third. And another ball. Two outs. Got him looking for the K. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. And the home team down a run. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Start of the fourth, stepping in, Anthony Volpe. And here it comes. And he gets that fastball by him upstairs.
Wow, good luck catching up to that one.
Zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Here's the catcher, Austin Wells. And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And another ball.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Two down, nobody on. Top half of inning number four. In the air, right field, Kepler. Should have this one. He's got it. And that is out number three. Ready to go, bottom four. And now for the Twins, Carlos Correa. And a curve is down and in.
Well, these Twins did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Kicks and fires. To the right side. Tosses to first. That takes care of Correa.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Trevor Larnach getting ready to hit. Base is empty, one away. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Chop to first. Bare hand grab. And very nicely done for the out.
He had more time than he thought right there. Probably didn't have the bare hand, but he made it look nice, that's for sure.
This is Willie Castro. Two down, nobody on. Bounced up the middle. Volpe fires to first on the run. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Twins retired in short order. They're down 3-2. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. Cody Funderburk.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Back to the top of the Yankee order, Gleyber Torres stepping in now for the Yankees. The pitch. And another ball, double-barreled action in the bullpen. Jay Jackson warming up for manager Rocco Baldelli. Okert also throwing. That's to third. Tosses to first. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. Here's Juan Soto.
I thought this was a fun note on Soto. In 2023, he hit home runs in Mexico, Canada, and the U.S. I don't think it matters where Soto plays. He's going to hit home runs everywhere he goes.
Next offering misses, and that's ball two. Right through there for a strike. Try to get him to chase on the changeup that time.
Down is full.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
One down, base is empty. And that one hammered. That's back. And it's out of here. He circles the bases, and they add on. It's 4-2. That's their third home run of the game.
They're having a lot of fun at the plate in this one. They've got the long ball working for them on autopilot. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit. Spent on some other pitches in this at bat. Was very patient, and it paid off.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. And there's the strike.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
And now the count is even. Just missed.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Bounce to Santana, and he takes it himself for the out.
Now back to first base, Anthony Rizzo.
Two outs, base is empty. Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. And he deals. That one off the mark, 2-1. And now a two-out opportunity for Giancarlo Stanton.
Really stayed true on that swing. It wasn't an easy pitch. Lefty on lefty. Pitch was a little down, a little bit away, but he committed to it. And his shoulder stayed square to the plate. Didn't try to pull off that ball at all. And that's why it jumped off the bat.
Now here's Giancarlo Stanton. Line drive. He's got it. And that'll end the inning. Another look at the long ball for the Yankees. It's now 4-2. Major League Baseball is on the show. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now for the Twins, Carlos Santana. Here's a 1-1. Inside, almost got it.
Well, these Twins need to bring up the quality of their bats and specifically their swings. You really can't pin it on one player because we've seen soft contact up and down this lineup. It's time to make some adjustments because this approach is just off.
The lefty fires. Swing and a ball popped up. Torres makes the catch, and there's one down.
The cause for these struggles is a little different for each hitter. For some, it's timing, and for others, it's mechanics. Whatever it is, they need to start hitting the ball harder.
Jose Miranda, the next Twin up to hit. Swing and a foul straight back. And a pitch. In the dirt, 2-2. The Yankees up by two, last half of inning number five. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Chases that one out of the zone. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at bat like that one. So the lineup flips over. Here's Alex Kirilloff. Swing and a bouncer. Throw on to Rizzo. Three up, three down, inning over. Nothing doing here for the Twins. They trail it here, 4-2. Back in Minnesota, start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading off, Alex Verdugo. Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
The 1-2. And that's another ball. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Jay Jackson warming up for manager Rocco Baldelli. Okert getting loose as well. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. That's down and in. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Leading off the Yankees. The shortstop.
Now, Anthony Volpe. The 1-1 is fouled off. Nobody out. Runner at first. And now the lefty, and it's even up. It's a good take. Fights it off, you'll see another. pitch. That misses. Full count, 3-2.
These first two hitters really making him work out there. Already 14 pitches this inning.
The pitch. Gets a piece and stays alive. And that is ball four, and the Yankees are in business. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boo.
Now the catcher up to hit, Austin Wells. He launched a solo shot back in the second inning of this one.
Yeah, that was big for these guys early on. Definitely helped them get off onto the right foot.
Pitch. And that's the inside edge. Two balls and a strike.
You know, these Yankees putting together some really good at bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. They really made that opposing starter work in this one. Ran his pitch count off, and now they've got an opportunity to continue making things difficult on the bullpen.
At the belt and fires. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Verdugo on second. Volpe on at first with nobody out. Kicks and deals.
Full count.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And the pitch. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Left-hand batter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Sizes this one up. Larnick puts it away.
And no, they haven't broken through in a big way in the runs column, but with the way they're grinding out at bats, it definitely feels like there's potential for more coming.
Oswaldo Cabrera will hit next.
Well, bottom of the order here, Boog. You got to go right after this guy.
As they look to pick up an add-on run, and the number 9 guy at the plate.
Execution of that curveball down and in. He gets it out of the danger zone, and you really can't do it much better than that. It's in the zone the entire way, so you have to swing as a hitter, but then just falls off the table and almost hits you in the back foot.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here comes Gleyber Torres. Two on, two outs. Right through there for a strike. Ripped to third, but handled. And that'll end the inning. Yanks strand a pair as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Down for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Victor Gonzalez.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So
this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
Now the number two hitter, Edouard Julien.
The second baseman,
Edouard Julien.
Ball and a strike. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
And here it comes. Fouls it off. Still one and two. That's a little bit low. And what a play to right, and that should be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second, and he greets the new arm from the bullpen with a double.
Everything came together for him. Recognized the break on that pitch early, and that allowed him to keep his front shoulder in. You know, it's easy to bail on those front row breaking balls, but a great job right there of level travel, then unloading a nice balanced swing.
And here's the catcher, Ryan Jeffers. Man at second. And ball four to a board.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way.
Now batting Max Kepler.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Ground ball right side, could be two. On to second, they get one. On to Rizzo at first, and they get the double play.
I think 4-6-3 double plays like that are way tougher than these guys make it look sometimes, because no matter how you do it, the feed from the second baseman is a tough one. That's where footwork really comes into play, but right there, very well done.
And here comes Carlos Correa. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
That one missed. Action in the pen down there. Ian Hamilton getting loose out there. Ferguson also getting ready. Ball Rizzo picks it up. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Twins wind up stranding one, still down by a count of 4-2. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Steven Okert.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Juan Soto now.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
Here comes a pitch. And another ball.
That's a ball.
Ripped it third and caught.
Man, that could have been a big swing in this game. Just unlucky. A really unfortunate time right there.
Aaron Judge at the plate. One down, base is empty. Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul. And they'll do it again. Base is empty, one away here in the top half of inning number 7. Hit hard on the ground to short. Correa over to first. And two away to start the 7th.
The batter, the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
And now the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away.
Two balls, one strike.
And that's outside.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
Fought off foul. Three and two. Payoff pitch. In the air, center field. Castro under it. Nabs it. And that is that. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the 7th. Number 50.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Righty delivers.
Ball.
Swing and a high fly ball in the air left field. That's back there. Reaching for it. Makes the catch.
These plays are so risky because of the slide. The last thing you want is to be forced to pop up and go chase the ball down because you missed it. But it feels great when it works. No harm, no foul there.
Here's the center fielder, Willy Castro. The 1-1. And
so
another ball.
Ball.
And he bunts, but that's a foul ball. A swing and a miss. Two down. Carlos Santana now at the plate. One, one down.
Outside ball.
The Twins down by a pair near the bottom of the 7th. High drive, base hit.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on the line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Fastball in for a strike, and it's 1-2. the tying run at the plate. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Tying run at the plate. Stays alive. And the righty deals. Right side. Soto gets under it. He's got it. And that will end the inning. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Jay Jackson.
Now
pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Here's Stanton now.
The designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Some movement in the Twins bullpen. Jorge Alcala warming up for manager Rocco Baldelli. Thielbar getting cranked up as well. 2-2 now. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. Here's the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. On the ground, right side. Santana steps on the bag. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth.
The bat, number 11, shortstop.
And Anthony. Now, Anthony Volpe. Two down, nobody on, and we're in the top of the eighth. Next one in the dirt. Wouldn't chase that time.
Full count.
Two outs. That's towards center. Castro has a beat on it. He's there. He's got it. And that is that. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth. Caleb Ferguson.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
On the ground, right side. He handles it himself. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Up next for Minnesota, the second baseman.
Edward.
And next for Minnesota, Julien. Edouard Julien. Lefty continues to work, but the closer getting loose in the bullpen. And a pitch. Knocks that one away and will do it again. The pitch. And that's in the dirt. Ball two. Just off the outside edge.
That's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Got him swinging. And there's two away. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
And he deals. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Right side. Collected by Torres, slings to first, and the Twins go 1-2-3. All set to start the ninth in this one. And now, Austin Wells.
Austin Wells.
Right-handed reliever. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Righty to the plate.
Ball low.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And downstairs. Line of the pitch. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Three and two now. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. So he battled through a long at-bat and earned himself a hit.
But when you see that many pitches in an at-bat, your chances of succeeding go up. And right there, we see the result.
And next for New York, Oswaldo Cabrera. Wells aboard here at first with nobody out.
Now batter
Jorge Alcala into the game.
Now pitching for the Twins, number 66, Jorge Alcala.
Here is Gleyber Torres. Good take by Torres. Man at first, one away. Kicks and fires. On the ground, could be two. Fired to second. And it's a double play to end the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. On to the bottom of inning number 9. 4-5-6 coming up. The Yankees 4 and the Twins 2. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Clay Holmes.
And I can't imagine any now, save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
Max Kepler digs in now.
Kepler.
Check swing, no appeal.
2-1.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Little chopper rolls foul. Absolutely frozen with the backdoor slider for strike three.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. This is his third strikeout, and this one rookie, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
One down, base is empty. Slapped foul. Shortstop takes the ball. Base is empty, one away here in the last half of inning number 9. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, it's kind of tough right here. Closer comes in, and he strikes out the first two hitters. It's hard not to feel defeated, and then this is going to go quickly. But you got to go up there, maybe try to find a way to choke up on the bat, spread out, put the ball in play, and maybe you can extend this inning.
One strike away. Misses that's off the inside. And yeah, that's ball two. And they'll do it again. Two-run game with two away here in the bottom of the ninth.
Sometimes it takes just getting away from home. Players can sort of come together, connect a little bit more than they do when they're at home with their families, and that can breed to success on the field, as we saw in this game today. Excellent win by this team.
And your final 4-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. We'll see you soon.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, four runs, seven hits, no errors. They left.